Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. Beta, today we are going to revise chapter Last Spring. Fine, and there are two parts of this chapter. After revising both the parts, we will be doing MCQs. I will be sharing the screen with you, okay? So Last Spring, very important. Why? Because it is having two parts in it. So many questions can be there, clear? Last spring means, firstly, let me tell you the meaning. Spring is the season of when all the plants are rejuvenating, flowers can be seen, fully bloomed trees and plants can be seen. Fine. So in this season, in spring weather, it is associated with growth, happiness, rejuvenation. Fine. But last spring means when growth is not there, when happiness is not there. So that's why author Annie Jung chose this title, Lost Spring. Because in the lives of these children, Sahib in the first part and Mukesh in the second part, they have lost their spring. They have actually lost the good days of their lives, and they are just leading very poor life, poverty-stricken life. Fine. So that's why name of the chapter is Lost Spring. Now, part one's name is, Sometimes I Find a Rupee in the Garbage. Fine. So why this is the name of part one, or this is a sentence, you can say topic sentence of the first part, because the main character protagonist is Sahib. Fine. This boy, he is a rag picker. He just scrounges the garbage dumps, and if he finds anything valuable, he keeps it with him. Clear? That's why the first topic sentence of this part is, sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. Otherwise, he never finds rupees in the garbage. But sometimes, why, it is a matter of sheer chance that he finds it. Fine. And second is, author Annie Jung is again the protagonist, because in both the parts, author will be interacting to the main characters, and then we will be getting to know these characters in a better way. And background is, Sahib belongs to Dhaka, Bangladesh. Fine, came from Bangladesh in 1971. Clear? So this is the fact we know about Sahib now. Fine. So now write down for a few points of this chapter, beta. Yes, you beta also. Aap bhi likho. Okay. Everyone, beta, please keep notes of these short notes of value points. Author meets Sahib every morning. First point is, author Annie Jung meets Sahib every morning. So as I told you, Sahib has left his home in Dhaka, Bangladesh a long time back, and he's trying to scrounge gold. What is gold here? Gold means anything which is which he can utilize in his life, which is valuable to him. Fine. So he keeps on scrounging gold in that heaps of garbage dumps and in the neighborhood where he lives. Fine. The author asks Sahib one morning that why does he do that? This is वैसे question का कोई meaning नहीं है. One person is, it is quite perceivable that if he is scrounging garbage dumps, he is a poverty stricken boy. He needs to find something. So author Annie Jung asks the question that why does he do that? Then he tells that because he does not have anything else to do. He does not have any work. He does not have any job. He cannot afford to go to school. So that's why he chose this job. So there is no school in his neighborhood. And then author asks that why don't you go to school? So again, this question is baseless. Though it is asked by the author, but a person who does not have anything to eat and anything proper to wear and even the shoes, that person cannot afford to go to school. So even then, author asked the question that why don't you go to school? And answer given by Sahib was, because there is no any school in my neighborhood. What does it show? The innocence of the protagonist. Okay. Then there are 10,000 other shoeless rag pickers like Sahib. So they are telling that people like him, they are 10,000 and more in number. Fine. And they do not have shoes to wear. They live in, and where they have taken refuge in Delhi. They are not living in the metro city. They are living on the periphery of Delhi or outskirts of Delhi. There is one place named Simapuri. Kindly note down that people from Bangladesh, they shifted to Simapuri, Delhi, which is at the outskirts of Delhi, which is not the metro city, fine. And Simapuri, that locality is on the outer edge of Delhi, and this is actually the structure of mud. Fine, very muddy area. It is not a posh area where people from the good backgrounds are living. So this place, Simapuri, S-E-E-M-A-P-U-R-Y, P-U-R-I, fine. It has, and how they are living, they have used mud to make their huts and houses. They are using tin and tarpaulin. Fine, there is no sewage facility, there is no drainage system, no 24/7 water, electricity and all. So they are living devoid of basic facilities of life in Simapuri. Clear? So this is the condition of rag pickers, those who have come from Dhaka, Bangladesh, they have shifted here. Clear? And fine. So then, why food is more important for them? Because food is the main thing. If a person is hungry, cannot think of anything. So wherever they find food, they start putting their tents over there. So they, you can call them refugees. They do not have a permanent place to live in. They have tents and tarpaulins and tins only, with which they make kacha houses. So wherever they find food, they shift over there. Fine, so they are not permanent residents over there. And in Simapuri, survival means rag picking only. They do not have any other option. Clear? Garbage to them is gold. So what is gold for them? Garbage, because they have to scrounge through the garbage and they have to find some valuable so that they can survive. Fine, so this is their daily bread and a roof over their heads. Fine, you can say. Clear? And then what is the name of this part? Sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. Why? Because sometimes Sahib finds a 1 rupee note or even 10 rupee note while scrounging this garbage heap. And then when he finds a rupee or 10 rupee, there is more hope to find something else. So they keep on searching in the garbage dumps. That sometimes they find thrown out shoes by a rich person because there is a hole in it. Find so some other valuable in that way. Fine. And Sahib, now let's talk about this character. Sahib, rag picker, fine. He wore those shoes when somebody thrown it, fine. And he was standing to watch people playing tennis wearing white dresses, fine. And Sahib is very fond of watching people playing tennis, and sometimes the watchman of that area, that club, he allows them to enter the garden area because there are swings in it, and sometimes he takes that also, fine. And after that, they have mentioned that Sahib is wearing discarded tennis shoes. It looks very strange over him because he's not having a matching dress, obviously, fine. And for the people who remained bare feet throughout the days, then author Ennis Jung has mentioned some stories that how people, they wished, they prayed to God that they once, that they should have at least shoes, a pair of shoes was so important for them that it was very difficult to buy for them. And then they used to pray to God only, fine. And then one day, every day, author bumps into this main character, Sahib, and she asks one or the other question to him. And every time gets an answer from Sahib. But one day what happens at the end of the chapter, Sahib one morning, he was not there picking the rags and all. He was not scrounging the gold in the garbage dumps. What he was doing, he was on his way to milk booth. Fine. Actually, and he was holding a steel canister. You know that canister in which teacups can be fitted. So he was holding that canister and he was going towards the milk booth. So then again, author gets to know that he works in a tea stall now. At the end of this part one, we realize that Sahib-e-Alam, uska name kya hai? Full name is Sahib-e-Alam. Sahib-e-Alam means Lord of Universe. And it is also ironical that name is Sahib-e-Alam and he is not a Sahib in his life. He's working as a servant only. So this is again ironical. So he has got a job at a tea stall. He works in a tea stall now. and he was getting 800 rupees. Kindly note down, fine. 800 rupees were paid to him for all, and all his meals also were given to him. Fine. And Sahib is no longer his master. Earlier, when author used to meet Sahib Alam, he was a carefree guy. He was a carefree boy who was scrounging the gold, watching the tennis, taking the swings, playing bare feet in the streets with his friends. But now he was no longer his own master. And his face has lost that carefree look. And he does not seem to be happy this time. But he was earning some amount. That's why he was working over there. Fine. So you can very well imagine that why chapter is named as Lost Spring. Spring is gone from the life of Sahib. Clear? That is part one. Now let me share the screen and ask me MCQs based on this chapter, and then I will move to another one. Okay. Yes, beta. Can you see the screen? Fine, beta. Thank you for telling me. Let me now answer. I won't be showing to you. Fine. I will click on the answer and they will show the answer. First question is, all the questions are about part two only in this. Yes, Sahib did not like to work in the tea stall. First question. Sahib did not like to work in the tea stall because he was getting only 800 rupees. He hated the steel canister. He was no longer his own master. He had to carry heavy bags now. So first preference is to offline student. Yes, Samyak, what is the answer? Have you listened to the question? I'm saying that why he didn't like to, the tea stall. He was getting 800 rupees. He hated the steel canister. He had to carry heavy bags now. And he was no longer his own master. Again, you're doubtful. Yes, what do you think, beta? Yes, the correct answer is, he was no longer his own master. You can see on the screen the answer. So this is a very good site. I found your answer is not visible. When I click, then you will be able to see the answer. Garbage to rag picker is money, daily bread and a roof over their head, gold or silver? Gold. This is very easy answer. See, answer now, daily bread, a roof over their heads is the answer they have given. Let me tell you why. Garbage to rag picker is gold. It is written. Fine. It is written in your book. But what is exactly it means for the rag pickers? It is their daily bread, a roof over their heads. That is also mentioned in the book. After mentioning that, explaining that what gold means to them. So correct answer is daily bread, a roof over their heads. For the rag pickers, food is more important than clothes, shoes, identity, shelter. In the beginning of the chapter, Annie's Junior has mentioned it clearly. For the rag pickers, food is more important than clothes, shoes, identity, or shelter. So raise your hand, participants, online students, Rana Gurjeet, you can speak, beta.
Ma'am, C option, identity.
Yes. So, correct answer, it is identity. For rag pickers, food is more important than identity. You know that they were living at Simapuri, at the outskirts of Delhi, where they were not having any ration or identity cards and all. For them, food was more important, not their identity. The squatterers, the word is squatterers. Squatterers means, again, refugees. In Simapuri, arrived as refugees from Bangladesh in... This answer to be given by Lakshit Sharma.
Yes.
Lakshit Sharma, I discussed already this. Yes, beta, what is the answer?
1971.
Yes, it is 1971. Correct answer. Now this I have not mentioned. The man from UDP was the son of a doctor, a teacher, a priest, an engineer. There is one more story in this. Now when they used to, okay, Anmol wants to give answer. Yes, Anmol beta.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, beta.
I'm priest, third C.
Yes, priest is the correct answer. So you need to read the chapters. We are revising, but not that way, the way we have done in the earth, because the chapters are very lengthy. So a priest's son, he ran to the temple praying to God that he wants a pair of shoes. And even after many years, when author visited the place where people used to pray to God that if they have shoes, that they don't want to lose it. They used to pray to God for this thing only. Sahib's full name was Sahib-e Alam, Shahenshah-e Alam, Shah Jahan, Mughal-e Azam. Very funny question this is. Yes, you can mute yourself, Anmol. Now, author advised Sahib, any Jew. Fine, author advised Sahib to go to school, college, club, or playground. Raise your hands. Offline students, I have given me the answer. Anyone can participate in this, beta? Kapil, are you there? I don't think so. Is it ending the class either? So let me give you school. In the beginning, I asked you that that was the baseless question, but author asked that you should go to school. Clear? So then, why did Sahib and his family move to Delhi? Why did Sahib and his family move to Delhi? Because the storms had swept away their fields and homes, because their village was flooded, there were landslides, there was a deadly epidemic in the village. Yes, Rasika.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the answer to this question, beta? Question is in front of you. Why Sahib and his family moved to Delhi? Very easy.
Because storms and swept away.
Yes, because storms had swept away their fields and homes. आपको पता होना चाहिए वहां पे बहुत स्टॉर्मी वेदर हो गया था. Their fields, their homes were swept away in the storms. That's why they shifted to periphery of Delhi, Simapuri. Clear? Sahib's profession was a cook, rag picker, bangle seller, driver. अब यहाँ पे जब आपने दोनों पार्ट्स कर लेने हैं, मुकेश एंड साहिब आलम, then you can get confusion. He was a bangle seller वाले profession में वो था. Fine, so rag picker है साहिब आलम. Clear? What change did any Zoom see in Sahib? Next question, MCQ. What change did any Zoom see in Sahib when she saw him standing by the gate of the neighborhood club? He lost his freedom. He lost his ownership. He lost his joy. All of these. Okay, you have given answer, Amarpreet. Amarpreet, can you give answer to this question? Srishti.
Remember all of these.
Okay, according to you, all of these. Yes, correct answer, beta. Sahib-e-Alam has lost his freedom, ownership, and joy altogether. What is metaphorical symbol of Seema Puri in the lesson? Let it be more difficult for you now. No, give me, let me give the options first, beta. What is the metaphorical symbol of Seema Puri in the lesson? What is a metaphor? When any word is used to make comparison, but not by using as or like. Fine, direct comparison is made by using some other word. That is called metaphor. Now they're saying, what is metaphorical symbol of Seema Puri in the lesson? Poverty? Seema Puri word ke liye kya hai metaphor? Fine, got it. Poverty, exploitation, enjoyment, a little hell. Anmol has given answer. Lakshit Sharma has given answer. Yes, Sukhmanjot, it's your turn now.
A, poverty.
So the answer is a little hell. Fine. Metaphorical symbol of Seema Puri. They have mentioned somewhere in the chapter. That's what I'm saying. You have to read the chapter thoroughly. Clear? Read it. How is Mukesh's attitude? Mukesh ka bhi humne padhna hai. Fine. So that's it. Baki sare jo questions hai, ek aur hai yahan pe. Ye same ho chuka hai. Yes. Last question of this part. What excuse do the rag pickers give for not wearing chappals? When author asked the students, asked the kids over there, that why don't you wear chappals? What excuse was given by one of the rag pickers? A, mothers don't give them chappals. Option B, they have no interest in wearing chappals. Option 3, there is a tradition to remain bare feet. All of these. Yes, Fateh Singh, are you there? Because out of 15 present students, now 11. Very casual view people are becoming when it comes to attending classes now. Fateh Singh, are you there? Attendance ke liye aaye bacche bas. So, all of these reasons were given. Fine, वैसे उन्होंने ये major answer था. That there is a tradition. ये author ने खुद find out किया था that there is a tradition to remain. Then one child said कि his mother does not give it. The other said there is a tradition. Fine. And somebody said that there is no interest. So all of these they have considered. Okay. So now we will be moving to the next part. I want to drive a car. Clear? I want to drive a car, write down second part. The characters of this I'll be writing now. Part 2. I want to drive a car. So this is the desire of the protagonist, who is different from the rigid system going on in his society. So main character is Mukesh. He hails from the family of bangle makers. Bangle making goes on in Firozabad. Firozabad is famous for bangle making. Every person, everyone in the family, you can say every person is involved in bangle making. So the major profession or major work in Firozabad is bangle making only. Har ghar mein bangles, different colors bangles can be seen. Women also are busy into this. Kids also are involved. And many people have become blind also, because bangle making is very tedious process. While making bangles, they have to concentrate on fire while molding the glass of bangles, and they have to sit in the darkness. Clear? And many people have lost their eyesight in this profession. In every family, there is one or the other person whose eyesight is quite, you can say, they are not able to properly see, or they are totally blind. So this is the, you can say, basic information. Then we have other characters in Mukesh's family. His father is there, his brother, then his bhabhi is also there, but you will be using the word sister-in-law, fine. Then grandmother of Mukesh, who is a true example of rigid belief. Fine, that one should follow the family lineage. We will continue this next week only. So basic information I have given you. Okay, Bell has gone, so we cannot continue today. Okay, beta, please keep joining the class.